else, right or wrong. Oh shit. Okay, so boom. There we go. Even be doing all of this shit. Just invite. Ain't even that anymore. Fuck it. Send me invite. My share screen still up? Oh no, it's closed. Cause I'm blind blowing, polo draw showing. Yo, so like. My freezer be making ice and shit. And I didn't even know I had a fucking, like, an ice thing in there. No, like, it's a regular ass. Yeah. And then, like, I don't have, like, an ice thing in there or nothing. That shit just be making ice. Yeah, I'm broke, though. See, yeah, I'll be. Bro, Derek Carr really got hurt. First open and he's still trying to play this man.
There's a look inside the iconic Caesars Superdome in downtown New Orleans. Today, it's the opener of the 2023 NFL season, as it'll be the Tennessee Titans taking on the New Orleans Saints.
You get me? I was trying to make sure you get me. My shit keeps switching for some fucking reason. Okay. Nah, it's good now. What you watching? Oh, boy. You about to see me get dealt with, boy. I've been trashing Madden. I've been playing fucking 2K.
On EA Sports. They'll elect to bring it out here from the end zone. And in hindsight, probably
this ain't even no regular Madden game either. This a user.
And now the Saints are going to take a timeout on defense. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Second leading rusher in 2022. Here's Derrick Henry. Call it no gain on the game's first play. And it's second down now. Well, if you look where that play starts, O-line versus D-line, that was a battle won by the D-line.
Yeah, and oftentimes it's won by quickness off the ball. Who can handle the guy across from them best? On that play, the defensive line did exactly that.
That's caught by his tight end, Trevon Wesco. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. 17 yards on that play for the Titans. Well, there you go, Charles, the first completed pass of his young career.
And we expect it not to be his last. Very good to get the first one out of the way, though, as he begins his career.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Running from the gun with Henry. And he'll get this one up
to about the 39 here. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3.
The success there, Charles, coming on the outside of the field, the ground game. Curious to see if that continues as we progress.
Yeah, we often talk about a variety in play calling and usually between run and pass. But in this case, with strictly the run game, you can be creative there as well. Run it inside, run it outside, keep the defense off balance.
Henry again on 2nd down. Nowhere to go that time. He maybe got a yard up to the 40.
Well, for the Titans in 2023, they figure to be a team that battles for a division title. At least that's what it looks like from my vantage point, Charles. What do you think needs to go right for them to win the AFC South?
I think some retooling, especially on the offensive side of the ball. And when you start with the offensive line, their pride and joy, they've got to rebuild that part of the team, because that's the engine that makes their offense run. Everything comes off the fact that their offensive line usually controls the line of scrimmage.
Now the throw on 3rd down, knocked away and incomplete.
Not quite sure that they envisioned a much better start to this game when they practiced all week, but they failed on that 3rd down play. That brings up 4th down, and they'll probably have to punt it away.
And look at this, they're keeping the punter on the sideline. They're going to go for it here on the opening drive. They'll run. It's Henry. And he won't get there. They stop him a few yards short of the line to gain. So they take a big, big chance here in their own territory. And you think the coach may have some questions to answer?
Yeah, and, you know, normally we focus on the media, right? The social media barrage that he's going to get for this one. How about on his own sideline and in his own way? I think the team's going to look at my coach. Why would we go for it there? I mean, no confidence in the defense. You don't like the punter. I mean, what's going on here? You owe us some explanations.
2nd and 10. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And that's going to be incomplete. Johnson was the intended receiver, and that takes us from 2nd to 3rd down. This set of downs started. They need a full 10 here to pick up the first down and move the chains. Out of the gun now on 3rd down. Pass to the sideline and pulled in. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. That 3rd down conversion good for 23. A first red zone opportunity of the new year here as they come up now 1st and 10.
Again,
he'll drop to throw.
He got us in the red zone.
And it'll be intercepted. And the Titans are going to take possession here. It's a touchback, and they'll take over at the 20-yard line.
Well, Brent, as they say in popular culture, this one's going to leave a mark because they can see the end zone, but it'll stay out of reach because of their error. All their offensive teammates have to give the quarterback right now offer a little bit of encouragement because what's done is done. Let's get them next time out.
They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Part of what we're seeing so far is the defense is certainly coordinated. Both levels doing their jobs in tandem. The back helping the front helping the back. The pressure got home on that last play and forced him to try and throw through contact and short of the sticks.
Escaping the pressure right.
Oh, my God, he ran right back.
The ball comes out, but this will fortunately wind up out of bounds. Nothing open downfield. He keeps it himself for 11 and a 1st down.
I don't know about you, but I can hear and feel the sigh of relief all the way up here in our booth.
That was palpable. The sideline, the friend there.
No doubt about it. Ball goes over the sideline, able to retain possession, no turnover. I know his coaches are screaming, just hang on to the ball, man.
Now a play fake here on 1st down. Over the middle, and there's a diving catch. It's another 1st down as they look his way again, this time 19 yards.
And not all spectacular catches are the result of a pass that maybe was not thrown quite right. Sometimes it's thrown in the perfect spot, and you have to just go get it. He did that right there.
No fear there in the middle of the field.
down. He'll drop to throw. And he's taken down here by the Saints. Gotta imagine the pass rush will be equally intense here on second down following the sack. It's second and 18. Flush to his right. Has got it, and his crew will take over at their own 45-yard line. A good starting spot for the Saints as they come up first and 10 at the 45. And now an audible here into something else. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. So they'll get nothing out of that play, and it's second down.
Well, that was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained, so they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He could make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly. Throwing again on second down, but this time it's incomplete. They come up to the line now facing a third and 10 after the incompletion. They'll set up to throw. Trying to get it to Thomas, and it's intercepted. And he's just across midfield and down at the 49-yard line.
I believe this is what you would call growing pains here, Parker, because this defense obviously took the challenge facing the rookie, and they wanted to help indoctrinate him to the NFL. So now the big question is, can he answer that challenge and rebound with plenty of time remaining in this game?
It's caught inside the 25. And he's going to get this one down to the edge of the red zone. That one nearly 30 yards, 29 officially. The first red zone opportunity for the Titans. First and 10 right at the 20. Buying time to his left. And he fumbled it. It's on the ground. Oh, and one of the linemen on the other side has got it. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. We're scoreless after one. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And they take over in a precarious spot here, albeit after forcing the fumble at the goal line. This is safety territory as they start from their own one. Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. Here's the option. In his seventh season now, here's Alvin Kamara. Pass the 20 for a short gain, second down.
I feel like I could see what he was thinking on that carry. Wanted to follow that big tackle through the hole. Ended up only getting 4 yards on the carry. I think he had designs on that one being bigger.
Second and 6. Quickly here, and that's complete. And he'll get this up past the 25 before he's out of bounds. Here now, third and a yard. Here's Kamara trying to run for him. And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. That'll back him up 2 yards and also bring up fourth.
When people talk about plays being blown up, that's exactly what they're talking about. That's Exhibit A for physical play.
They'll try and throw for it here. He's got his running back out of the backfield, and he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. A curious decision to go for it, but it pays off with a first down. To throw. And that is incomplete.
They geared up and took the deep shot downfield, but it turned out it wasn't one-on-one coverage. Extra defenders in the area, and that one winds up incomplete.
And second and 10. He'll look to throw again. They'll set up the screen now to Kamara. And getting this just shy of midfield. They'll spot it at the 49. The Saints passing game in sync and moving the football. It's a first down. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. Into the hands of Perry, complete. And he'll be stopped right there at the 28. Call that a very strong gain of 24. They'll look to throw again. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Zone coverage there, and they were playing deep. That makes it obviously a little bit harder to run by guys. And that time, there was not much of a window to get the ball in there, and it winds up incomplete.
Now here's a throw right side, taken in by his tight end. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. First catch of the new season for him, and he picks up the first. A chance for their first points of the season here as it's first and goal. Back to throw again. That's complete to his running back, Kamara. No gain on the screen there at second down.
Well, another completion there. And what a big moment in a young quarterback's life, that first NFL start. And Charles, obviously they want him to win games, but if they're looking at him under a microscope in this first month or so, what do you think they're hoping to see from him?
Well, for every question they'll have for him, they should have for themselves as a coaching staff, because it's not just how quickly can he learn the offense, is what they can teach him, right? How can he build a relationship with his receivers? And, of course, how open is he to learning? And, of course, how open are they to giving him things that he can put in place on the field?
A big play, if you think about it, right now in this season opener. It's third and goal. Not liking the look, they'll change the play. Kamara. And he'll get him a bit closer as he's down to the 2-yard line. Only a yard that time, so now a decision to be made here on fourth and goal.
Well, they certainly had success throwing the ball on this drive and not as much running it as we just saw once again on that last play, stopped after a very short gain. But I wouldn't abandon the run totally, because otherwise, pass rushers just tee off on your quarterback. It makes it very, very difficult for him in that situation.
And he's got him. It's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans. Taysom Hill, a 2-yard touchdown grab. And the Saints drive the entire length of the field, 99 yards for the score. Lutz with the extra point, and that makes the score 7-0. The ball upright on the tee, and the Saints kick team moves it away.
Angle, I feel like our team played a lot different.
The return man down to a knee, and this will come out to the 25-yard line. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. And one of the things we like to hit on every year are the new rule changes. And we got a few for 2023. A lot of procedural, having to do with deadlines and roster construction and such. But two kind of caught my eye, Charles. One is the option to fair catch a kickoff and have it come out to the 25 like it does in college. You like that?
I don't like it at all. I don't like it in college. I don't like it in the NFL. I wanted to have something different, and I really wanted the special teams coaches to be a little bit more involved. But I do understand why the league is doing it. They believe it promotes safety, and it's hard to argue against that.
What about, this is the other one, guys can now wear the number 0. We've already seen some make the switch, Calvin Ridley, DeAndre Swift, Braxton Berrios, amongst others.
Yeah, and you know something, when you see those guys make that move, I don't mind that at all right? A little more expressionism for these guys, I love it. I just think we didn't go far enough. What about double 0, like Jim Otto used to wear, or Kenny Burrow used to wear? Let's add that back to the NFL jerseys.
A nifty bit of scrambling there. 12 yards, first down. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. They'll look to throw here on first down. And it'll be incomplete with just 6 seconds left on the clock.
Well, a momentary speed bump there with that throw partner. The defense had other ideas, and they're trying to mount a small stand before this drive reaches the end zone.
looking to throw. And oh, look at that, a diving catch. And we're going to get a timeout with 2 seconds remaining in the second quarter. It's a quarterback sneak, and he is over the line for another rushing touchdown.
Is he a quarterback or is he a tailback?
A great effort there with his first career touchdown in his first career game. And the Titans have a chance to tie the game here in the final seconds of the half. Caleb Shudak on to try the point after. And he starts his new year off on the right foot as well, as this kick is good.
Oh, the new PPD.
So still time for the kickoff here. 1 second to go in the half as this one is away. Kevontae Turpin now from his end zone. First half in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number three. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. And we'll see if week one fatigue becomes any kind of a factor as we are back underway in the second half. And here comes a return from the middle of the end zone. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one. Set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. It's a tie football game here. What do you think, Charles, the message was at halftime?
Well, I think that they probably just looked.
Here's a diving catch right side. Just his second catch of the game so far. This one moves the chains.
To me, there's nothing like watching rookie effort in the NFL. So excited to be there. They're going to give you the max on each and every play, aren't they?
Well, he proved himself on that catch, that's for sure.
I think he may have proved himself to the point where he's going to get a second here.
That's caught inside the 20. A big-time play there for New Orleans. 53 yards.
When you get into the second half of the tie ball game, you start realizing that every play takes on a bigger significance, and this is pretty significant right here. This is where you start putting the pressure on that secondary, and that's a job well done there.
And he'll get about three just outside the 10, stopped at the 11. Second and 7 with our score tied at 7, but they're planning to change that soon. Only question, will they get 3 or 6 out of it? And he'll fight his way down inside the 10 to the 9-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there, and it's going to lead them to third down. They'll need 5 on this play to move the sticks. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. Steps away to his left. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. That'll go as a pickup of 8.
Brandon, that's a gamer move right there. Facing third down, steps up, calls his own number, and nearly makes the house call. If I'm the coach, I let him take another one right here.
And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans. Kamara taking it in from a yard out. And the Saints have taken the lead as they go right down the field and score on the opening drive of the second half. Lutz good on the extra point. And that makes the score 14-7. And the Saints kick team booms it away. From a couple yards deep. He'll bring it out of the end zone. And they'll start this drive just across the 30. Pretty nice work on the return. Tennessee offense about set and ready to go. And this game was all square at halftime, but now they find themselves down 7 following the opening drive touchdown here in the third quarter.
And they need to take a good, relaxing, deep breath, don't you think? Because right now they might start to feel like they've got to play catch-up here and start matching them point for point. But it's still too early to get there. They can still run their offense. Plenty of time to get back in this game.
Quick hitter here. It's complete. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. And quickly, they get to the line. Back to throw now on first down. Open man, that's Henry. And he's got this to the 30 before being taken down. So on the other side of the field now, it's first and 10 as they've got things rolling on this drive. Now a dump off here, complete. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. So here's a first and 10 now, down inside the 20. He'll look to throw. Now the ball comes loose. And this is picked up by the Saints. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
I know one thing, the team that had the ball and was driving, they're going to feel horrible. But the team that was on defense, I think we got to give them a little bit of credit, able to hang in there and force a key turnover.
In the red zone, though, had a chance to tie it and an opportunity missed. That's going to go as a loss of 4, and it'll be second down. He'll drop to throw, eluding the pressure right. Be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long way out there, but it'll be third down.
They've been trying and trying, but they haven't sacked him yet. He's been able to get away and make plays. Tried to make another one downfield right there, but to no avail. They'll have to keep up the pursuit, though, and not let him get high.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Back to throw here. Flushed out right. He's going to get that to his running back out of the backfield. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. Able to convert on 3rd and 14. A terrific play call.
I don't care what level of football you play. This one was a universal, wasn't it? When we were kids and we played touch football, remember we get in these positions and you just say, everybody go along and hope someone would come free.
Now a nice play defensively on first down as this is knocked away and incomplete.
And that's another throw that could have been intercepted. Part of this, you credit the defense. They've been really stingy. But he's also made some really questionable throws. And that's another one right there.
Again, he'll drop to throw. Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. 19 yards to pick up there. Move the chains. So operating from Tennessee territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 45-yard line. They'll pound it up the middle with Kamara. And he'll take this ahead for about 4. Second down coming up. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin.
And he is going to be taken down. And that should be the final play of this third quarter. So they'll get a little extra time to come up with this third down play as we played 3 quarters. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Saints on third down. They've hit at 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. This will be a tough 3rd and 18. Now they'll change things up.
critical play in this football game, because if they pick up the first there, that clock keeps rolling.
Has to be a little frustrating for them, because they know that if they pick up a first down there and continue to eat away at the clock, really increases their chances of closing this one out. Now they're likely going to have to give the football up and sweat it out on the sideline.
He's going to fire one deep, middle of the field. And he's got it. Touchdown, Saints. Jerome Johnson, 53 yards. And the Saints are closing in on a winning start to the year as they extend their fourth quarter lead. Lutz with the extra point, and it's now 21-7. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And he'll just sit on this one as their drive will start at the 25. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. Last time out, remember, they fumbled the football. That led to the touchdown. And, Charles, they were in the red zone. They're looking for Jefferson, but this is intercepted. Picked off by Pete Werner. And he's able to get it back to right around the 27. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. Going to throw deep for the end zone. Looking for Thomas. He's got it. Touchdown, New Orleans. A great play there. 27 yards. And the Saints are looking good here in the season opener as they're able to extend their lead. He has really settled in throwing the football, and that touchdown here in the fourth quarter gives him a pretty comfortable cushion.
He may be a rookie, but he's playing like fourth quarter, and the QBing is easy. How about this guy? Youngster, not worried about anything, just cutting it loose and having fun.
And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And he doesn't even get this to the 10. He's taken down at the 9.
In this position, trying to get back into the game, teams are looking for a spark from their special teams. That's not what they got, though. They got a setback, and they have a long field to cover if they want to try and put points on the board.
And he's going to be brought down. Back at his own 6-yard line. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. Second and 13. Justin Jefferson bringing in the slam. And he's able to get this one all the way past the 30. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. He'll look to throw. And the Saints pressure gets him. Brought down for a sack. No surprise there. Chase Young wrecks that play with a sack. And you hate to say it with a rookie quarterback. He's done some good things, but overall, looked a little bit overwhelmed back there, hasn't he?
He certainly has. But in his defense, he hadn't had a lot of time to throw the football. You like the way I said that? In his defense.
In his defense. I got it.
You see what I did there?
Yeah, he needs better protection, that's for sure.
Okay, ready?
So now 20 yards to go on second down after the sack. Work to be done. They're going to look to throw. And this one caught downfield by Evans. And they work this well upfield across the 45. And now they're in the hurry up. They'll look to throw now on first down. Escaping the pressure right. And he's left with no option here but to throw it away.
They lead big, and a major part of that has been how they've taken their play to a whole new level this second half. No points allowed since the break, and you can add another incompletion to the total number that they forced in this runaway contest.
Now this one to his tight end out on the right side. They get 7 out of that, so they're left with a 3rd and 3. Now they'll throw here out of the gun. And that went off the mark a little late with the throw.
And that's another play that's painted the picture of this game overall. It's been a blowout. It's been continually fueled by big turnovers and stops for one side and an inability to advance the ball from the other.
All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on 4th down. They're going for it. It's complete. Swings it out to his running back. And he's not able to get
midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Perry. A very solid gain of 27. Still throwing the football here, even with the big lead.
Yeah, I know you and I came up in a different era, and we think about sportsmanship and all that. Other people think about fantasy points and getting their numbers. That's all they care about right now.
A good running there by Kamara on first down as he takes this ahead for a gain of 5. Good gain there on first down. That keeps him in a running situation, probably.
They did everything right on that play, didn't they? They got the leverage up front, good blocking, nice hole for him, ends up picking up nice yardage, stays in bounds to keep the clock rolling. They are in charge of this scenario right now. They want to stay that way.
And not in any rush offensively. And he's going to be intercepted for the third time thus far. And the Titans are going to take over once again, and they'll have it at their own 8-yard line. Certainly not what he was hoping for, Charles. That's now 3 interceptions in this ball game.
But there's a lot of knowledge to be gleaned every time you throw an interception if you do things the right way. And hasn't there been a pretty darn good quarterback along the way who threw a lot of interceptions early, learned from them, and became great later?
He's got a man complete. A big play that time for the Titans. 51 yards. So the Titans in possession of the football here as we get you reset. They've got a first and 10 as they search for a late score. On first down, he'll drop to throw. Oh, going for Jefferson downfield. And this one almost intercepted. Had a chance to come down with it in the end zone, but could not hang on. Now a second and 10. Now back to throw. Airing this one out for Evans. And it's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Tennessee. Mike Evans, 41 yards. And the Titans have got it back to a 2-score game here in the fourth. And they're going to get the 2-point conversion, caught in the end zone. And that cuts the lead a bit further. So they go with a pass there on the 2-point try and able to convert it, Charles.
And a good job by the offense figuring out their 2-point play and using it well. It's interesting how people are using the strategy nowadays, though, isn't it?
It really is, and I don't know how much that one, that particular play, factored in, but with the PAT moving back in 15-16, that kind of changed things, didn't it?
It's really a part of everyone's strategy now. When I talk with coaches and when we sit with them, they always talk about they actually have 2-point periods in practice now, something they never really did before.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. Now they are really in the driver's seat here, enjoying this lead late in the fourth quarter. The defense does have all 3 timeouts, but at this point, doesn't look like it's going to matter much. A gain of 3, second down. A run with Harris out of the shotgun. And he powers his way up past the 30. And the offense moving quickly to the line. They'll run again. And Harris is not going to get there. Great work defensively to stop him short. The Titans going to use the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with just over a minute to go in the game. And with things looking pretty good on the scoreboard, they're going to keep the offense out there and go for it here on fourth. Now they go for it on fourth, but this one is going to wind up incomplete. The Saints' decision to go for it backfires. And the Titans, they've got the football back, and they've got it in great field position. They go play action here on first down. And he's going to be taken down. Pressure gets there back at the 39-yard line. They'll come up now. This is second and long. On play action, they'll throw. Oh, he's thinking end zone for Evans. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down. This crowd turning up the decibel level. It's third and long. throw. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. And he will have a Titans first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
They'll look to throw here on first down. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Marcus May with a pick. And the Saints are going to take possession here as they've got it at their own four-yard line. We've got to have two hands on the football here as they run on first down. And he's going to take this out past the 10 to about the 11. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and three. Well, CD, always a little extra excitement for week one, and one of our early window games here in week one on a Sunday comes to a close. Good to be back in the booth with you, my friend.
And it's good to be back in the booth with you as well. And we know that not everyone's going to start the season 1-0, right? Half the league is going to have a loss on their record. But everyone's going to have to build off of that opener. And how many coaches tell us every single year, you make your most progress between week one and week two. We'll see how both of these teams progress the rest of this season.
So for the Saints, that'll be a happy locker room as they start the season 1-0. And they will hit the road next week to take on the Carolina Panthers. Meanwhile, for Tennessee, they go down to defeat here in the opener. And they'll get a chance to redeem themselves at home next week. And for Charles Davis and our entire crew here at EA Sports, I'm Brandon Gordon saying so long, everybody.
They just threw, mind you,